The novel is about Sophie Stark, who is a young woman who wants to become a filmmaker, and she actually does become a very successful and brilliant filmmaker. But in the process, she ends up manipulating and sort of hurting a lot of the people who are closest to her. So I think the story is really about what it takes to create great art, and sometimes great art can come at a great cost. So those are some of the questions that I was thinking about when I was writing the book. Some of the other characters in the book, people who were very close to Sophie Stark during her life. One is Allison, who is a little bit of Sophie's muse. She is her favorite actress, and they also have a romantic relationship. In some ways, I think Allison is the love of Sophie's life, but their relationship becomes very tumultuous. There's also Daniel, who is a young college basketball star who Sophie meets in college. She makes a documentary about him that becomes her first film. And Daniel's interesting to me, as the writer at least, because at first he seems like maybe he might not be so complicated, you know, he might just be a simple character. But then when you get to know him more, you realize that there are some surprises that he has in store, I think. And then there's also Robbie, who is Sophie's brother. He lives in her shadow a little bit, but he also loves her very much and tries to protect her from other people, sometimes unsuccessfully. There's also George, who is Sophie's producer. I like him because he lives in Los Angeles, which is where I'm from. So his chapter was fun for me to write in that way. He also loves science fiction, which I also love, so he and I are close in that way. And there's also Ben Martin, who's a critic, and you read some of his reviews of Sophie's work in the book. I also like Ben Martin because I used to write film reviews a long time ago, so I drew on those a little bit when I was thinking about his character. And then there are other smaller characters throughout the book, but I think those are really some of the main ones who are affected a lot by Sophie Stark. I think American literature draws inspiration from a lot of things, certainly from current events. Events in America today have been very bizarre in some ways, especially with the election, so I wonder if we'll see some interesting literature coming out of that. Also, I think American writers are inspired a lot by film, as always, but I think something that's interesting in the last maybe couple of decades is how inspired, at least I've been, by television. I think other writers maybe would say the same. TV has become, you know, just as complex and interesting as film. I know for me, I love science fiction TV shows, and I always have. Now I'm obsessed with Game of Thrones, and I'm excited to see what George R. R. Martin does next. So I don't maybe draw direct inspiration from Game of Thrones, but certainly from the sort of pageantry and romance and the big stories. They inspire me at least emotionally.